You look the screen. You look the screen here. स्क्रीन दिसते का?
हो सर दिसते
ओके, नाउ स्टार्ट द रेस्पिरेशन. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट ह्यूमन रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम, डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ द रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम ऑफ ह्यूमन बीइंग और रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक. व्हेन यू लुक द ह्यूमन रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम, जनरली इट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम एक्सटर्नल नॉस्ट्रिल व्हिच लीड इनटू द नेसल चेंबर, nasal chamber which lead into the internal nostril, and this hole we called as a nasal cavity. Okay, nasal cavity, and this nasal cavity separated by nasal septum, or nasal chamber separated by nasal septum. Now these are the external nostril, here the entire nasal cavity, and nasal cavity further open into the what we call as a pharynx. Nasal cavity, they are open into the pharynx. By opening, it is called as a glottis. Glottis, because in the pharynx, this previous part I already explained in the last lecture. So we come to the pharynx. So pharynx is a common chamber, and here the food, they are going to the food pipe, and ear, they are going to the ear pipe. So when we concentrate on the ear pipe, that is the pharynx, the ear pipe, they are open into the pharynx. This opening we call as a glottis, and glottis which lead into the larynx, and larynx which lead into the trachea, and trachea further lead into the bronchi, and bronchi which lead into the two lungs. This is the right bronchi, this is the left bronchi, and finally right lung, and this is a left lung. And this diagram shows the here, this is a diaphragm. This is a diaphragm. So this is the entire chest or thoracic cavity or chest. So this human respiratory system, generally here, when you look this first, that is the pharynx, up to the pharynx, the remaining part I already explained in the last lecture. So we come to the pharynx, and the remaining part just I want to explain here today, and that is the pharynx, then glottis, then larynx, then trachea, then bronchi, then left lung, that is right lung, in addition to the diaphragm. So I mentioned here the pharynx is a common chamber for food and ear. So after pharynx, so here I mentioned the pharynx divided into two parts, that is nasopharynx and oropharynx. Oropharynx lead into the digestive system, nasopharynx lead into the respiratory system. So in the nasopharynx, respiratory system, they are open. By opening, it is called as a glottid, and glottids lead into the larynx. So what is the larynx? When you look this diagram, then this entire we call as a larynx. Here, this is epiglottis. Here, these are the different cartilage. I actually mentioned in the last lecture, larynx is made up of six cartilage in case of the human being. We are concentrated respiratory system of human, not to the other vertebrates. So human, the larynx is made up of six cartilage. So main cartilage we call as a thyroid cartilage, arytenoid cartilage, cricoid cartilage. So these are the different type of the cartilage. Beside that, there are total six cartilage. They are made up of larynx. Okay, larynx. And this larynx, when you look inside the larynx, vocal cord. Vocal cord. So this is opening of larynx. This is opening of larynx, and in the opening it shows two vocal cord, that is a true vocal cord. This is we call as a true vocal cord, and this is we call as a false vocal cord. Okay, true vocal cord and false vocal cord. So false vocal cord does not produce sound. I mentioned in the last lecture, in case of the mammal, only mammals are produces sound. Only mammals are produces sound because there is a persistence of. But the vocal cord is not present. Amphibia, reptilian, both never produces sound. So the bird sound production, there is a special box we call as the syrinx. And what is the syrinx? I mentioned in the last lecture about the birds. But in case of the mammal, there is only, and because of the vocal cord, mammal produces sound. So especially true vocal cord. False vocal cord does not produce sound. Means for sound production, false vocal cord not useful. And true vocal cord, they are essential for sound production. Okay. In addition to that, when you look at the epiglottid. So epiglottid means this is a type of the cartilage, a flap-like cartilage with the glottid. And this epiglottid close glottid when food enter the esophagus or food pipe. That is called as a solving. When solving, the epiglottid close glottid, and therefore the esophagus are easily enter into the esophagus. They are never going to the respiratory system or respiratory pipe because of there is a flap which we call as a epiglottid. Okay. So I mentioned here the pharynx lead into the larynx. Larynx lead. So when you go to the trachea, then this is a tracheal system, trachea. So this is a trachea. These are what we call as a primary trachea, then primary, trachea divided into the primary bronchi. So before going to discuss about the primary bronchi, when you the trachea is elongated pipe. Cartilaginous pipe, and this cartilaginous pipe externally there is a supported by complete C-shaped cartilage. All cartilage, they are not complete, but it is a C-shaped incomplete cartilaginous ring which are supported to the trachea. C-shaped cartilaginous ring which are supported to the trachea, and cartilaginous ring, they are help when pressurely or pressurely air release out of trachea. So during this movement here, there is a collapse. To avoid the collapsing of trachea, trachea are supported by cartilaginous ring. That is a C-shaped cartilaginous ring. Now this trachea enter into the thoracic cavity and further break into two bronchi. So this bronchi we call as a primary bronchi. Now this primary bronchi also supported by complete cartilaginous ring, not C-shaped cartilaginous ring, complete cartilaginous ring. Bronchi, primary bronchi supported by
सर एक कोई ना